So last year we made this film. It was called Milk, and it didn't really go as well as I wanted it to. We didn't get as much critical acclaim as I'd hoped we would. In fact, we didn't even pass the class. But this year we're doing it again. We're making Milk 2%.
What the team is putting together, I think it's really good. We're working on the script. It's almost done. I think this video will probably be the best video we've ever produced. I'm very proud of what we've made so far. And, well, we haven't gotten the whole crew back together yet, but we're working on it.
Okay, so we've got the majority of the script done, but we really just need a better ending.
We need something great. Something to top the original.
I got it. We find out he's been dead the whole time.
Excuse me?
No.
Yeah, maybe just something simple. You know, I get my milk, everyone's happy, the end.
What if he wakes up and it was all a dream? How'd that be?
That'd be okay, but take a look at this.
This isn't bad at all. We really just need Evan for this role.
I'll go talk him into it.
You can try.
Yeah, so Evan was my supporting actor in the original Milk. He was kind of there. He wasn't very good. I was extraordinary. And now he's dropped the class, so we need to go find him and convince him to join us for this
$6.90 for every 100 feet, plus, 50% tax for being a bitch ass hoe, and then take away $3.50, because fucking snake me in. And, you know, we get $299.95, man.
What? No, I already told him I wouldn't. Milk was just this awful, horrible, wretched excuse for a film. It actually made me drop the video production class.
Come on, dude. You gotta do it. You were the best part of Milk. It was a standout role.
That video brings back traumatic memories for me. Everyone saw it, and they thought I was the worst part. My mom saw it, and she wouldn't even talk to me for a week, man.
Okay, look, dude, I get it. Milk didn't do so well, but we finished the script for this one. It's much better. We gave your character some depth. And he gets more screen time, he has a heart to him, it's great.
Really?
Yeah, I can say without a doubt that it was 100% the best script I've ever read.
Well, if it's that good...
So you'll do it?
On one condition.
What?
My name comes before yours in the credits.
Okay. That's a no can do. You see, I'm the lead actor, and my name is coming first.
Not if you want me in your film.
Fine.
So, with the original Milk, I feel like the critical reception wasn't as good because the critics don't like comedy. They just, they can't take it very seriously. So, in this movie, in Milk 2%, we're gonna try to steer away from the characters like drinking breast milk and selling their kidneys. It's gonna be a more darker, grittier film. And I think it's going to top the first Milk on basically every single level.
You know, I think what's really going to set this film aside from all the other ones we've made is there's a real passion to it, you know? There's a real heart. We all care about the characters we're playing. And we all work together so well. Like, the boom guy, the camera guy, we all work together so well. We have the best chemistry. What did I tell you? 3 feet away at all times.
Okay.
3 feet away.
Sorry.
3 feet away.
Sorry.
That was like... 2.123, okay? 2.1, 3 feet away. I could do your job. I could do it for you, okay?
Sorry.
Okay?
Okay.
Get out of here. Hey.
Yeah, can't scare me sometimes. I legitimately fear for my life.
I don't think I could ask for a better crew.
I'm gonna be playing as the milkman in this film. The second I heard that the dudes were making a sequel, I jumped on board immediately. I even helped write the script. Yeah, I think that the sequel's gonna be way better.
Peter!
Than the original.
Make up time.
Gotta go.
Hello everybody, I'm so glad you could make it to the final viewing. I know not all of us can make it. I really should have known Evan had that severe milk allergy, but you know, stuff happens and you just have to roll with it. But yeah, It's been a really, you know, it's been a hard journey. We've had some struggles, but you've been a great crew, and so hopefully we can enjoy this final production.
Smells like a milky morning. Holy cow. I have your milk. If you ever want to see it again, you must pay me $100,000, no cups, or you'll never see your milk again. The milkman. Yeah. Get the stuff. It happened again. I'll take the usual.
Exco, give it to you. Fuck, wait for you to get it on your own. Exco, deliver to you. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real. With the non-stop, my problem's stainless steel. Go hard, getting busy with it. But I got such a good heart that I make the motherfucker wonder if you did it. Damn right, and I do it again. Cause I am life, so I got to win. Break bread with the enemy. No matter how many cats I break bread with, I break who you send to me. You motherfuckers never wanna know you, but your life saved. Bitch, and that's on a life day. I'm getting down, down, like a nigga said freeze. You won't be the one ending up on his knees, bitch, please. If the only thing you can't steal was came out to play, stay out my way, motherfucker. First we gonna rock, then we gonna roll, then we let it pop.
Where is he?
I don't know who you're talking about.
The man that stole my milk. Look, kid, even if you don't know him, you know the streets and where I can find him.
Look, I can't help you find your milk, but I can help you find something better.
I don't want your organic garbage.
I'll say it once more. Where is he?
Okay, look, here's what I can tell you. There's a new guy in town. He calls himself the Milkman. He's Russian, and rumor has it he's lived 20 years of his life in the Gulag. He killed 3 guards to escape, and then came to America to rule a milk empire.
Where can we find him?
I hear that you can find him in his lab underneath the parking lot, off of North 13th Street.
You thought you could take me down. You thought wrong. Pay me what you owe me, or the milk gets it.
You think you're gonna get money out of me?
Yes. Yes, I do.
I came here to kick ass and drink milk. And I'm all out of milk.
Shoot me, and I drop it.
I've learned not to cry over spilt milk.
No milk today, my love has gone away. The bottle stands forlorn, a symbol of the dawn. No milk today, it seems a common sight. But people passing by don't know the reason why. How could they know just what this message means? The end of my hope.
So what'd you think?
I mean, it's enough to pass the class.
Yeah, but like, out of 10, what would you give it out of 10?
I don't know, like a 6.
A 6?
Really?
A 6? Are you serious? A 6? Oh my god, this was the best film ever made. This was like a 10 out of 5.